green may be a great colour, and I think one has to recognise it's a pretty expensive colour as well, and it's the beneficiary of all this investment to look after the environment and to provide better service that has to pay.
A row has broken out over a fund set up to help a 2-year-old child from Merthyr who's suffering from incurable cancer. After paying for Jamie Belusky to go to Lourdes, organisers of the fund are now refusing to hand over the remaining money, more than £2,000, and the issue is set to go to court. Jamie's father says that by the time it's settled, it could be too late to help his son. A 6-year-old girl who suffered brain damage at Morriston Hospital in Swansea has been awarded £500,000 compensation. It's the largest ever settlement for medical negligence against West Glamorgan Health Authority. Rhiannon Phillips from Brynaman suffered irreversible harm when staff at the hospital failed to deal with complications during her birth. The police have welcomed long sentences handed out to 5 men who bound and tortured a guard during a robbery in Newport. Tim Hartley reports.
The men went to Security Services Limited on the Leeway estate, fully equipped for what was described as a professional robbery. One guard was tied up and told that if he didn't cooperate, parts of his body would be cut off. The raiders eventually got away with just £480. The 5 men admitted robbery and were sentenced to a total of 50 years in prison.
Clwyd has had more bad jobs news today. 55 people are being made redundant at the CMB packaging factory near Wrexham. The Labour MP, Dr. John Merrick, says it's further proof that high interest rates are crippling local businesses. And that's all the news of Wales so far tonight.
Hello, this time last week we were issuing warnings for snow and blizzards. One week on, the weather is certainly much quieter, but we are issuing warnings for fog anywhere over England and Wales tonight, freezing fog patches with visibilities less than 50 yards. And even in some other parts, like Northern Ireland and Scotland, there could be some fog patches around as well, and some sea fog through the Northern Isles. So anyone driving tonight, going to catch a plane, or even meeting someone from a plane, then do expect serious delays. Around the coast, we'll keep some cloud. There'll be the odd spot of rain around, so that'll keep the fog at bay, and the frost too, because in many parts of the country, a widespread frost, especially from the Midlands into central southern England, the temperature's as low as -6, so icy patches to watch out for as well. And not only that, but the air quality is poor over parts of Northern Ireland, the Midlands, central southern England and the southwest, and it looks as though it's going to deteriorate as we hold on to this area of high pressure right throughout the weekend. Now tomorrow the high pressure itself drifts to the northwest. This little system coming down the North Sea could be interesting during Sunday. It could bring some cloud, rain, perhaps even some sleet across parts of England and Wales. Tomorrow then, I think we'll probably be dividing the country in two. The eastern half and some parts of the south, a good deal of cloud around, perhaps the odd spot of rain, some sleet in the hills, and certainly a lot of fog, very slow to clear. Some southern and western areas will be much better. Here the fog will be much thinner, and there'll be a good deal of brightness and sunshine, and very little changing during the afternoon, and certainly in some of these central areas, the fog won't clear at all, and that means the temperatures are going to sit about freezing. Cold over much of England and Wales. In the north and west, the temperatures normal around about 8. On to Sunday, well, we'll have this cloud and perhaps some rain, sleet coming across England and into Wales. The rest of the country, once the mist and fog was cleared away, a good deal of brightness around, but temperatures still really a little bit below average. And Monday, we'll have dry air coming into many parts of England and Wales, so that should alleviate the fog problems. The cloud and rain, as it comes into the west, tending to break up, so it'll stay dry and sunny. That's it from me. Good night.
In Thursday's Wales Playhouse, Gerald James plays Denzel Williams, a man with a grievance.
Now look.
The King's shilling. I expect that's what all this is about.
Too damn right.
I'm afraid the airy librarian has asked me to come in and deal with some discrepancies. Perhaps if we were to have another little look at home.
Do you hear that? The damned woman called me dear.
Is it just a storm in a teacup?
It's nip in the bud time, I'm afraid. Denzel has developed a habit of blowing things up out of all proportion.
I thought you'd be pleased. Your wife's...
Which shows how little you know, and my wife has nothing to do with this. It's the principle.
It's a book.
That's written off Thursday, 9:30, BBC Two Wales.
Well, now back to BBC One Wales, Friday full of films. And Mel Gibson and Sigourney Weaver starring in Peter Weir's tense and exotic thriller set in the Indonesia of 1965, the year of living dangerously.
Oh. June 25th, 1965.